So welcome to lecture number 8. This is inside EC core components, and what we are going to discuss today, it is CPU. So first of all, what is CPU? The CPU is responsible for interpreting and executing most of the commands from computer's hardware and software. CPU की responsibility ये है कि जितने भी कमांड्स हैं जो सॉफ्टवेयर कंप्यूटर के सॉफ्टवेयर या कंप्यूटर के हार्डवेयर से आ रहे हैं उनका इंटरप्रिटेशन करे प्रॉपर एंड देन उसका एग्जीक्यूशन करे. सो बेसिकली सीपीयू इज़ अ चिप इज एनी स्मॉल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइस दैट कंटेन्स एन इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट. यानी एक डिवाइस है, इसके अंदर एक इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट है जिसको हम बोलेंगे सीपीयू. CPU are used in digital computers and are semiconductor component where most calculation takes place. We already know कि वो semiconductor से बनता है और digital computers जो आजकल हम use जो हम computer use करते हैं, it is already known as digital computer. As can be seen in this picture, the CPU chip is usually in the shape of rectangle or square and has one notched corner to help place the chip into the computer properly. Notched corner है ताकि हम जो CPU है उसको computer में properly fit कर सकें, computer में यानी motherboard के अंदर properly fit कर सकें. It is already attached directly into the CPU socket. With the help of that lever or you can say hinge, we are protecting our CPU from the other elements. So it is basically stored inside the pocket of CPU, or it is also known as CPU socket. और फिर CPU के ऊपर हम एक fan रखते हैं so that it can prevent from overheating. मतलब एक heat sink के लिए एक fan रखना पड़ता है CPU के ऊपर ताकि वो overheating, CPU को और motherboard को overheating से बचा सके. So now here you can see the basic basic units of CPU. CPU has memory unit, control unit, and arithmetic and logic unit. Input unit gives data to the CPU and CPU interprets and decodes the data from input device and then it gives to output device. Now memory or storage unit, it stores all the data and the instruction required for processing. It stores intermediate results of processing. It stores the final results of processing before these results are released to an output device. All inputs and outputs are transmitted through the main memory. If you remember that registers were the temporary locations where the memory location or any data that was stored, so that the processor works on that. In microprocessor 8085, if you remember, we were calling accumulator as a processor register. Why? Because each and every process is whatever it is taking place, it takes place on that particular accumulator. So registers are temporary storage areas which are responsible for holding data that is to be processed. यानी accumulator और general purpose registers जो थे उसमें हम डेटा को टेम्पररी स्टोर करते थे ताकि जो भी ऑपरेशंस है या कोई भी प्रोसेस है जो परफॉर्म होने वाली है उस लिमिट तक के लिए हम उसको स्टोर कर सकें. आफ्टर परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ ऑपरेशन वी विल सिंपली ट्रांसफ़र द डेटा फ्रॉम द एक्यूमुलेटर और जनरल पर्पस रजिस्टर आइदर टू आउटपुट डिवाइस और टू द मेमोरी और any other external hard drive. This data is further used by control unit. There are some registers that are set aside for specific tasks. These generally include program counters, stack, and flags. Okay, so all those registers were having specific tasks, like program counter was used to keep track of each and every instruction. Stack and flags, stack pointer and flags were having their own task. Stack flags were used for status. It was also known as status register and was very much important for logical operations. Next is control unit. There is a circuitry in the control unit which uses electrical signals to instruct the whole computer system for carrying out or executing already stored program instructions. Its name clearly shows that it controls and coordinates computer components. It extracts instructions from memory and decodes and executes them. In fact, it regulates the flow of information through the processor. In short, it can be said that this component receives, decodes, stores results, and manages execution of data that flows through the CPU. इन शॉर्ट हम ये बोल सकते हैं कि कंट्रोल यूनिट जो है वो पूरे डेटा का फ्लो का ट्रैक रखता है. जो भी डेटा आ रहा है या जा रहा है उसको प्रॉपर इंटरप्रेट करना, उसका प्रॉपर एग्जीक्यूशन करना, उसको डिकोड करना, ये सारे काम कंट्रोल यूनिट के हैं. अगर अरिथमेटिक एंड लॉजिकल ऑपरेशन उस पर करना है तो पर्टिकुलर ALU यूनिट को प्रोवाइड करना. दिस बेसिकली इट manages or and tracks the flow of data. Now arithmetic and logic unit. Arithmetic and logic unit is also an important unit. This unit consists of two subsections. First is arithmetic section, second is logical sections. Arithmetic section, the function of arithmetic section is to perform all arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, or all complex operations are done by making repetitive use of the above operations. मतलब ये जो basic operations है उसको हम repetitive use करके हम complex operation कर सकते हैं. Next is logical operations. Function of logic operation is to perform logic operations such as comparing, selecting, matching, and merging of data. Now coming to CPU performance properties. So first you can see these are the number of factors that are responsible for a CPU performance. First is CPU speed, the number of operations that can be done per second. Word size, the largest number that can be operated on in one operation. Data path, the largest number that can be transported into chip in one operation. Internal cache memory, the amount of internal high speed memory that the chip includes. Now starting with CPU speed. So the CPU speed of a computer is used as a means of measuring how well it operates. Like the megahertz or gigahertz value of a computer is an important measure of its power. All other things being equal, a faster clock means faster execution and better performance. Means jitna fast clock hoga, utna hi faster execution hoga aur utna hi better performance hoga. All this thing is the meaning of CPU speed. Aur uski speed hamesha kisme batayenge, ya to megahertz mein ya to gigahertz mein. Next is word size. Word size is the number of bits. I'm repeating again, it is the number of bits the processor can interpret and execute at a given time. Any computer can be programmed to manipulate any size number, but the bigger the number, the longer it takes. The largest number that computer can manipulate in one operation is determined by its word size. In microprocessor, what was the size of word? It was taking microprocessor 8086 was taking one word data. while microprocessor 8085 was operating on only half word or you can say 8-bit data. But जो word size है वो ये बताता है कि कौन कितना longer या फिर कितना largest number of bits है या फिर word size जितना बड़ा होगा और कम second में या कम time में वो उसको operate कर सके या execute कर सके, ऐसा जो word size होगा ऐसा जो size होगा उसको कहेंगे word size. And word size is the number of bits. I already told it is the number of bits the processor can interpret in a given time. Okay. But we already know कि जितना बड़ा number होगा उतना ही ज़्यादा time लगता है. But हम CPU ऐसा design होना चाहिए जिससे कि वो बड़ा वर्ड बड़ा साइज का वर्ड होगा या फिर जो डेटा है जिसका वर्ड साइज बड़ा है उसको कम टाइम में वो एग्जीक्यूट कर सके. बट फिर ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि बहुत बड़ा करने जा रहे हैं और फिर क्या बोलते हैं उसकी स्पीड कम होती जा रही है. इट शुड बी ऑप्टिमम. नेक्स्ट इज डेटा पाथ. डेटा पाथ इज द हार्डवेयर दैट परफॉर्म्स ऑल रिक्वायर्ड ऑपरेशंस. Means data path is the hardware. What are the hardwares? For example, hardwares are arithmetic logic unit, registers and internal bus. All these are hardwares. They are performing different operations. CPU in a computer contains data path that route data between these functional units. Means कौन से डेटा को कौन से रजिस्टर में ले जाना है, कहाँ से ले जाना है, कौन सी बस के थ्रू ले जाना है. This kind of thing is known as data path. Next is internal cache memory. You already know what is cache memory. Cache memory is a very high speed semiconductor memory which can speed up CPU. Right? Cache memory क्यों किस लिए use करते हैं? ताकि वो CPU की speed बढ़ा सके. It is a very high speed semiconductor memory that can speed up CPU. Holds those part of data and program that are most frequently used. यानी अगर कोई हम ऑपरेशन कर रहे हैं जिसमें जो डेटा है या फिर कोई प्रोग्राम है जिसको हम बार बार यूज़ कर रहे हैं तो वो कैश मेमोरी में स्टोर होता है, वो भी टेम्पररी. द पार्ट्स ऑफ डेटा एंड प्रोग्राम्स आर ट्रांसफर्ड फ्रॉम डिस्क टू कैश मेमोरी बाय ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम फ्रॉम वेयर CPU कैन एक्सेस. मीन्स हार्ड डिस्क से कैश मेमोरी पे लाना पड़ता है. कौन लाता है? ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. कब? जब हम किसी प्रोग्राम को यूज़ कर रहे हैं या उस प्रोग्राम को कोई प्रोसेस यूज़ कर रही है या फिर सिर्फ ट्रांसफ़र भी कर रहे हैं तब हमको डिस्क से कैश मेमोरी में लाना पड़ता है. व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ इंटरनल कैश मेमोरी? इट इज़ फास्टर देन मेन मेमोरी. इट कंज्यूम्स लेस टाइम्स. इट स्टोर्स डेटा फॉर टेम्पररी यूज़. मीन्स इट अगर वो फास्ट है, कम टाइम यूज़ कर रही है और स्टोर डेटा को टेम्पररी स्टोर कर रही है, सो मीन्स इट इज़ एडवांटेजियस टू आवर कंप्यूटर. इट स्टोर्स द प्रोग्राम दैट कैन बी एग्जीक्यूटेड विद इन अ शॉर्ट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. यानी ऐसा प्रोग्राम स्टोर करती है जो हमको तुरंत ही यूज़ करना है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ़ आई एम प्लेइंग अ सॉन्ग देन फॉर सम मिनट्स आई हैव जस्ट पॉज्ड इट but I want to use it again, so that doesn't mean it will go to the hard disk again, that particular song. It stays in cache memory so that after some time or you can say after few minutes I can access it again. Another thing is disadvantage. What is disadvantage? Cache memory has limited capacity and it is very very expensive. So here we are finishing our lecture number 8 and the reference is tutorialspoint.com. You can visit it and thank you.